Welcome to a Chuckwagon MTG concept deck tech. Today we explore a Gate Colossus deck. But before you run off to your F&M to put the hurt on that one opponent who's been rocking your Friday nights with that Tier 1 Is It Drake deck, remember, this deck is more fun than practical, and as a concept deck, it hasn't even been played yet. So don't get ahead of yourself because you might get bit. So we're playing lots of gates. Gate, 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 gate. All the gates. But we need to get the gates out quickly because they all enter tapped. So you basically end up a turn behind. Well, okay. You end up a turn behind if you're on the play. But if you're on the draw, you're like two turns behind. Anyway, we'll need some help. Okay, so to grab those gates, you're going to need three copies each of Open the Gates, Circuitous Route, and District Guide to cherry pick the gates you want and to get them on the battlefield. So what colors do you need? Well, take a look at the converted mana cost and color breakdown in this description. As you move from lower to higher converted mana cost, it starts with green as the most important color. And green has a home all the way up to the 4 CMC spot. And the next most important is probably red. With red, you can cast your gates ablaze, and this is your board wipe. It does damage to each creature equal to the number of gates you control. If you're fetching for a gate and your opponent doesn't have any creatures out yet, you might want to go for your blue so you can play your growth spiral. That has card draw and can help accelerate your stupid slow mana base because we're playing all the gates. Gate. Gate. Gates. So Gatebreaker Ram is your first real board threat. It enters as a 5/5 at a minimum since you're playing nothing but these stupid gates. And now it's time to reap the reward of a deadly 5/5 sheep with Vigilance and Trample. In the 4 CMC spot, you have Domri, Chaosbringer. This planeswalker for 2, a red and a green, houses an ultimate that could be a win condition on its own. But let's get practical. Because it's practical to play nothing but gates. Gate, gate. Gate, gate. Plus up Domri and get an extra mana, and you get to give your creature Riot when they enter. That means you can give them a +1/+1 counter or give them haste. You can also -3 it to dig for 2 creatures. With both ramp and card advantage, Domri is the perfect planeswalker for this idiotic deck. Now it's time for your big boy, Gate Colossus. Gate Colossus can hit the battlefield as early as turn 4 with some ramp. Of course, it will be targeted for removal, but we're cool with that. All we have to do is drop another gate, and it comes back to the top of our library, and we can cast it again. And while we're not discussing a sideboard in this concept deck tech, you might want to keep some copies of Thud there. You sat Gate Colossus to Thud, 8 damage to your opponent, play a gate, get it back, do it again. In the 6 CMC slot is Gatekeeper Gargoyle. For 6, you get a 9/9 flyer. That's right, a 9/9 flyer because we're playing nothing but gates. Gate, 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 gate. And you've earned it at this point. It's a 3/3 flyer and it gets +1/+1 on it when it enters for each gate you control. At this point, you know, at the point where you're making a comeback, your life total is probably hurting because you've been playing nothing but gates and doing stupid tricks with giant sheep. So you play Archway Angel. For 5 and a white, you get a 3-4 flying angel that gains you 2 life for each gate you control. If you cast it for its 6 CMC, you're going to gain 12 life. Because we're playing nothing but gates. But if all of that isn't enough to destroy your 10-year-old kid at the kitchen table, you even have Chamber Sentry. For X, you get a construct that enters the battlefield with a +1/+1 counter on it for each color of mana spent to cast it. So it's coming in as a 5/5. Then you can pay X and tap it, remove X 1/1 counters, and it does X damage to any target, any player, any creature, any planeswalker. 5 damage. Tap it on Teferi, bang. Tap it on Sarkhan, bang. Tap it on Goblin Chainwooler, bang. Tap it on Carnage Tyrant. Well, you get the point. Then you just pay 5 different colors to get it back from your graveyard and do it again. So that's our concept deck tech for Gate Colossus. We'd really like to hear your ideas. I'm sure they're better than the gate. But we want to hear your opinions, even if you think we're full of sheep.